Okay, now we're gonna go ahead and get started. The first style that I'm gonna do is the invisible part. Now I'm gonna take a product called Grow Protect Solution. And this product is used for quick weaves or any kind of weave that you bond in. It's very good to put on the hair to mold down so that the glue don't stick to the hair. And I'm gonna take this product and apply it on top of her hair. Now I'm using the longer pieces of the 27 piece instead of the shorter pieces. And that's all up to you. Now to give me a longer look in the front, I'm gonna go ahead and cut the side because that's gonna give me my guide. Nice look. Or you can take your feathered comb. That's the flat look. Or you can take your feathered comb and just rake the hair back. And you can see the heavy layers that I put in the hair. And now you have your feathered look, the invisible part, and it looks very natural. And this is my finished style, the invisible part. And this is my finished sew-in cap technique. Welcome back, and thanks for joining me in this last segment. I'm gonna be showing you a wave technique using short hair. I've been getting a lot of requests, so I'm gonna bring you the wave technique. Okay, we're gonna go ahead and get started. When you're starting the wave technique, because I'm adding hair weave to her hair, you wanna make sure that the hair is dry. And as you see, the hair is flowing, it's nice, it's shiny. A lot of people think waves are old, And as you can see that this is 2010 and we're still rocking the waves. And now this is my finished spike style. A lot of people like, they like movement. And the reason for that is because I didn't apply a lot of chemicals, products on her hair. It's very lightweight. And trust me, the oil that I use has a lot to do with, and how much I use has a lot to do with the flow of the hair. The less you apply, the more body you have. Now this is my finished style of my feather look. Now I have completed my finished style with the short cut with the curly hair.